Tonight we're going to have 6 persons presenting their prepared speeches. Time allowed, as usual, 7 minutes. Except for Bruno. Where's Bruno?
He's
still on the way.
Come on. You speak about the bear walks in.
Bruno.
Yes. Let's welcome him, man. Come on.
Bruno will speak for 8 minutes and 88 seconds. Why is such a weird number? Very auspicious in the Chinese way. And of course, after every speech, the speaker shall receive an evaluation. But first, for the first speaker, I will need to ask for 2 evaluators. Two. And our first speaker will be Joyce Khong, who is a registered nurse. Member of the Singapore Nursing Board, she specializes in research.
Mouth-to-mouth
resuscitation, I'm not sure. You have to ask her yourself. Currently a clinical and sales trainer for a global medical device company. Her passion has always been the field of training, clinical research and self-development. Today, she would like to share with us the topic, Mindset Matter. Specifically focused on stress. So if you're feeling stressed at work, you're not alone. According to Joyce, you can ask her later, stress isn't always bad. Our mindset on stress matters. So let's welcome Joyce to tell us a little bit more.
I would like to kickstart this session by asking you, do a takeaway, like asking you by a show of hand, how many of you experienced a lot of stress in the past 12 months?
A lot of stress.
Just today is enough. Okay, very good. And how about very little stress? No? Or no stress at all? Relax, chill. Okay. Very good. So means this talk is for you. Okay. So my intention for this next 7 minutes is to share with you a study that have changed my mindset on stress. So how I view stress and how it affects my performance. So let's dive into it. So this is a study that came from Shona, are you okay?
Yes.
Don't be stressed, okay? We just started. Okay, so this is a study that came up from Harvard University. So in order to explain to you how this study works and what is the outcome of this study, I would like to invite all of you to be my participants. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay, great. So this study is designed to stress you out. It's a social stress study. So the objective of this study is to find the relationship between the cardiovascular and cognitive responses to stress. So imagine you are the participants invited into a Harvard University laboratory, and then you are being told that, okay, everyone is here. You're being told that you are to do a 5-minute impromptu speech to a panel of expert evaluator, like now, like people that are sitting in front of me. And you're supposed to do this impromptu speech in 5 minutes, and on the stage, bigger than this, and with the bright light and the camera right in front of you, and we are going to talk about your personal weaknesses, okay? And the trainer is trained to, the evaluator is trained to give you discouraging non-verbal feedback, like this. So, you got the idea? Okay, so when you are sufficiently demoralized, you are the part two. Here comes the part two, whereby the participant is asked to do a math test. So, okay, so that is the presentation. And the math test is, I would like you all to do together with me. So, the experimenter is also trained to give you a non-verbal feedback and also to harass you during the methods. Okay, shall we do this together?
Yes.
So I would like
yes.
you to start with 996 in increment of 7. And I want you to do as fast as possible and as loud as you can. Okay, shall we do it together? 996, start. Faster, faster. Please. You are not very good at this, is it?
No.
No, stop. Someone out there, the guy over there, gave the wrong answer. Yeah, we have to start all over again.
Okay.
So, you get the idea. That's how these participants were being told to do the stress test. First to do the presentation and then the math test. So, guess what is their response. So, if you are a participant in this study, you probably feel a bit stressed out by now. And because you're being watched and being harassed by the researcher, and when you're stressed, what do you experience? You probably have pounding heartbeat, breathing faster, and probably bring out some cold sweat, right? So normally we interpret this kind of physical changes as anxious, anxiety, not coping well with pressure. What if we can change another way of looking at it by seeing this heartbeat faster? Faster heartbeat is actually help. The heart is pumping harder to provide more blood supply to the muscles for you to get ready for any response that you need for the challenge. And when you're breathing faster, because they are providing more oxygen to your brain so that you can be more focused, right? So that is exactly what this study it's about. So before they went into the laboratory to do the stress test, they divide them into two groups. Group A were being shown a 3-minute video that says stress is debilitating, stress is harmful, stress is bad for your health, stress will make you unable to focus well, unable to perform well, and then you are will affect your health. So the 3-minute video is all about stress is bad. Another group, Group B, also shown a 3-minute video that says stress is enhancing. Stress helps you to perform better. Stress, the body is helping you to face the challenge that you are experiencing now. So, what do you think, which group will have a better result?
Group B.
Group B, yes, well done. So, Group B actually have a better result. So in a normal stress response, when our heart beat faster, our blood vessel actually constrict. So if we are constantly on this this state of cardiovascular health, it's not very good, because normally when people feel very very stressful, that's where it will lead to heart disease, cardiovascular disease, or we call heart disease, such as heart attack, stroke. So this is not very positive. Where else, for people who is from Group B, the participant from Group B, when they see stress as helpful, enhancing, helping them with the challenge and performance, their blood vessels actually stay relaxed, even though their heartbeat is the same as the Group A. So their heart still continue beating as fast as Group A, as if like anxious, but their blood vessel, this is something that like intangible, we cannot see from outside. So, their cardiovascular profile is much more positive than the other group that think that stress is debilitating and harmful. So, and what's more important is that this is the state, this is really like a moment when you feel joy and courage, although you're having the stress, but you know that your body is preparing you to face the challenge. Okay, so my talk here really, my objective here really is to share with you that stress is not always as you think is bad. Stress can be seen as good as well. So the next time when your heart is pumping hard, and please remember this talk, that actually your body is preparing you to face up to the challenge. Thank you.
So now we know that when you get excited, it's also stress. Okay, let's have our first evaluator.
Clap, 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 clap!
I like the speech in the sense that it's very, the intonation is very clear, pace is slow, it's good. Perhaps one thing that you might want to be more conscious of is actually you use the word so a lot of times.
Stress on
stress.
And I thought that maybe for the presentation where you want to stress us, help the 996 minus 7 was in the actual test itself. But you need not use that because I feel that that doesn't give enough stress. Okay, make something
more challenging. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thank you.
Especially to Joyce Khong. The moment she opened her mouth, such a sweet voice, all our ears are glued to her voice.
Wow.
Especially the guys.
Yeah.
You la.
Of course, I'm one of them. I'm a guy. She has a very sweet voice and very attractive. With good vocal variety, where when we listen to her, it's not monotonous. It's she go at a very good pace, and she asks questions that brings all of us into the speech, her speech, where it involves us. It involves us and make us participate in her talk, as if we are part of it. We become part of it. And it makes us undergo the test. That is also part of it, where we become part of the, and actually stress from the title, recognizing arousal improve cardiovascular and cognitive response to stress. If she were to give such a long title, I think it's a bit technical for us. But she make it, she don't use such title. She make it very simpler for us, easy for us to understand. So that's why we are with her. But I will agree with the previous evaluator that a lot of horse wheelers are in her for this. But on top of that, you could also pause for more effectiveness. Because throughout the whole speech, you have been rattling on. So sometimes it's good to pause a bit for us to catch up with it. Okay.
Joyce, how many times have you spoken on this topic? How many times have you made presentation?
How many times have I made presentation? Mm. Or just this
I know here is the first time.
Here is the first time. Before that, many times.
Many times. I want to commend you on one thing. The moment you sit out here, you really engage your audience. This is the most important part of the delivery. As soon as you engage them, everybody will be glued to you. And I was glued to you. The introduction was very good. You had beautiful body language. Eye contact was looking with everybody. Your hand gestures, your movement, everything was perfect. The only thing I think you need to improve is some of the vocal. You need to raise high and low. Your pace was excellent. Now I want to talk about your... This is a beautiful one. When you put this on, everybody was talking to you. So this is a beautiful introduction. This is also, when you put this, we're speaking on this on a little while. This one, okay. And this one as a... Who was it? So,
Kira.
Yeah, Kira was saying this is
not easy.
Also good. Yeah. It may not be too easy, but it's quite confusing, you know. You start, when, the moment you put this, everybody starts to work on your mind, right? So, do not put this first. The moment you put, everybody trying to get the answer. Maybe. So, you are distracting them. Alright? Distract. This is the part you have group A and group A. Now, when you are speaking about group A, use the pointer and point. So everybody will focus on that, they will not look at here because you are pointing there. When you come to this part, you just point here and everybody will look at this part. So the laser will direct the eye of the audience. This is the only part I think you need some. Did I see this just
now? No.
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 Alright.
So no.
That's the only part because we have shown that.
Okay.
You will make a very good speaker. Very good. Just have some more training and control your more variety for your vocal. That would be excellent. Alright? Let's give her a round of applause.